Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I wanted to share the tools and tech I use to break away from being employed, which also helped me to start my own business. But at the same time, I wanted to let you know the tech stack is not the most important part. Here's why. When I started my journey, I was obsessed with finding the perfect tech stack. I thought it would be key to success, but what I found along the way is that it is just a means to an end. What really matters is creating something valuable for your users. Your product and how it serves your customer should always come first. Before I jump into the tech stack, I want to make one thing very clear. There's a huge difference between being employed and being an indie maker. When you're employed, you want to work as effective as possible in a larger group, which means you should have docs, a typed code base, tests, pull requests, and review. All this helps to work together on a larger code base and have a common understanding. But as an indie maker, your number one priority is to make sure your customers are happy with the solution you have created. So in order to fulfill this, you kind of have to be fast. And this also means you have to make sacrifices on other ends. Like, you won't have any reviews, you won't have a documentation, and you won't have tests. Because at the beginning, adaptability is a huge factor when it comes to building a product. There are numerous tasks at hand and you have to prioritize according to the needs of your business. Sometimes you have to pivot quickly and focus on tasks that directly impact your business and customer satisfaction. And of course, the end goal is to generate revenue. And making revenue is not always connected with the typed codebase. So a developer who is employed has very different priorities than one who is an indie maker. So if you are employed, your number one priority might be collaboration. Because I think when you can collaborate with different teams and understand different code bases, you can have the biggest impact for the company. And as an indie maker, your number one priority, especially if you're getting started, might be generating revenue. And if that's the case, you don't always have time to write tests or have a typed code base. Because there are so many tasks you have to fulfill and you have to set priorities. Now let's talk about my tech stack. Even though the tech stack is not the most important thing, it can still make your life a lot easier having the right tools. So let's start with the front end. I'm using Nuxt.js, which is the server-side rendering framework for Vue.js. All my products like Resume Photo, Chapterize, 7 To-Dos have been built with Nuxt.js. And you might be wondering why I'm not using React, which is way more popular compared to Vue. I have used React as a senior engineer for the last couple of years, and I also created a bunch of different applications from very small ones like a prototype to super complex ones across multiple teams. I always felt like when using React, I have to write a lot of code to get things done. And I didn't feel the same way when I was using Vue. You definitely have more control when you use React, but sometimes you just want to get things done. And that's why I love Vue. You get things done. Vue has a lot of pre-built things that makes life easier. Of course, there's no right or wrong here. You can choose whatever you want. React works great. There are multiple applications out there using React. But for me, it is Vue. So let's continue with the framework I'm using to write CSS. For the longest time, I didn't use anything, but recently I tried to implement Table in CSS. I kind of have a love-hate relationship with this one. It helps me to spin up UIs super quickly because there are already ready-made templates and components. But on the other side, once the project is getting larger and larger, I have so much noise in my codebase, which I really don't like. So right now I tend to use it when I want to build something very quickly and get it out and see if it can make revenue. But for example, in Resume, I didn't use Tailwind. Oh, and I'm also not using any other UI libraries. So I have written all my components by myself. And I think if you understand CSS and design, it's not that hard to build components. So let's move to the backend. I'm using Firebase for all my projects. Firebase is from Google and they have a super simple UI with backend services, real-time database, and authentication. Pretty much everything you need when you want to build a SaaS application. I think I discovered it like 5 years ago and I really never switched to anything else. Firebase integrates really well with my Nuxt.js frontend and the real-time database still feels like magic. And on top of that, I can use JavaScript in the backend because the backend is written in Node.js, which is a huge win, so I don't have to learn a new language for writing backend code. I also tried AWS for certain backend tasks, but the UI is just bad. I even made fun of it on LinkedIn that I don't understand how to use AWS and that I need a dedicated person to guide me through it. And a person from AWS, an account manager, I think, reached out on the post and said, hey, I can help you with that. But I think it's missing the point if I need a person who can guide me through the UI. I know AWS can be cheaper and or more powerful, but at the same time, the UX is so bad that I'm wasting so much of my time just trying to understand what I'm doing there. And when I need more power or want to scale my project, I can also switch to GCP, which is also from Google and stands for Google Cloud Computing. And the great thing is, if you have a Firebase project, your project is also in GCP and you can just extend your services from there. For example, on Resume, I have a few services which require more computing power than Firebase is offering, so I just created a new backend service on GCP. Alright, let's start with ChatGPT. ChatGPT has been a game changer since it came out. It changed the way how I build my products. It affects so many different aspects of my project, like from writing code to coming up with ideas and also writing the copy for the landing page. Oh, and in my last video I shared how I'm using ChatGPT to build a new feature for ResumeFollow AI. If you're interested in that, you should definitely check it out. It's not really tech, I guess, but of course we want to collect money and get paid. For that, I'm using Lemon Squeezy and Stripe. I tend to use Lemon Squeezy whenever I start a new project because it's really simple and easy to add to your project. Both platforms offer a lot of different options to collect payments. So you can have subscriptions, one-time payments, license keys. But once I'm generating a good amount of money, whatever that is, I switch to Stripe because Stripe has less transactions fees than Lemon Squeezy. Stripe is harder to add to the project, but once the revenue is growing, it's definitely worth it. I feel like Vercel is either loved or hated by the community. I can't tell, but I have used it for like 4 years now for all my projects as well, and I couldn't be happier with it. Vercel has made CI/CD so simple for me. I can just connect my GitHub account with Vercel and push my changes to GitHub, and the pipeline gets triggered automatically. Depending on the branch, they will either push it to master or create a separate URL for each branch you have. You can also add multiple domains to a single project, and you can have multiple projects on the platform. But there's one thing I don't like about Vercel. I have a lot of projects and sometimes I want to give a member access to a single one. But that's only possible with the enterprise model. I feel like this is such a basic and essential feature to have on their lower plans as well, but only enterprise has it. The whole gist of my tech stack is how can I be more efficient with my time and get faster results. And GitHub Copilot is, for me, autocomplete on steroids. I think I subscribed to the yearly plan pretty much immediately once it came out. The time and speed I gained with using Copilot has been so huge that I basically just said, yeah, here, take my money, please. I think I got easily like 5 times faster with Copilot than I could write code on my own. I know a lot of people don't like Copilot, but as an indie maker, it is a lifesaver. Definitely recommend it. Using these tools, I've been able to create and grow my projects. So when I built ResumeFollow AI, I used Nuxt.js for the frontend, connected it with Firebase for the backend to store custom information, used Tailwind to style the components, and ChatGPT to write the landing page, as well as to debug a lot of tricky code. Being an indie maker and being self-employed means you have to constantly learn, adapt, and iterate. I had to learn new tools, get rid of old habits, and rethink the way how I structure my time. But the most important thing is your success, or the success of your product, doesn't rely on your tech stack, but on how well you understand the needs of your customers. If you liked this video, please leave a like and share it with someone who might need to hear this. And if you have a question about my tech stack or the journey, drop a comment below. I would love to hear from you. That's it from my side. See you in the next one.